says it's withdrawn its ground troops from southern Gaza to prepare for future operations. The Prime Minister, Benjamin Netanyahu, has insisted his forces will complete the elimination of Hamas in the territory, including in Rafah, where more than 1 million Palestinians are sheltering. Police in Bradford have named a man they're hunting in connection with the murder of a young mother. The 27-year-old woman was stabbed in the city centre yesterday. Judith Moritz reports.
The attack happened just after 3 o'clock yesterday afternoon in bright sunshine in a busy corner of Bradford. A young mother pushing her baby in a pram was stabbed multiple times in the street by a man who ran off before anyone could stop him. She was taken to hospital, but died of her injuries. A knife was found at the scene, but police say they can't be certain whether the man responsible is still armed. They're looking to 25-year-old Habibur Masum and say the public shouldn't approach him. He's believed to have known the woman involved.
The former football manager, Joe Kinnear, has died at the age of 77. He was diagnosed with dementia in 2015. Joe Kinnear took charge of a number of teams throughout his career, including Wimbledon and Newcastle. On the pitch, Liverpool have been denied the chance to go to the top of the Premier League after they were held to a 2-2 draw by Manchester United. Mo Salah secured the point with a penalty in the dying minutes. The Man United manager, Erik ten Hag, said he hoped his side would now push on by qualifying for the Champions League next season.
Top four, we will keep fighting for it. It's still possible. We have to believe in that and keep fighting for every point, for every game. We need wins. And the good thing is we can put ourselves in winning positions, but we have to learn to bring the win over the line.
And a large flightless bird that made a bid for freedom by swimming across a river has been caught after more than 4 months on the run. The rear, nicknamed Chris, escaped from a farm in Norfolk in November. The bird's now been reunited with his girlfriend after being spotted in a paddock about a mile from his home. And the weather, the showers will ease in the southwest of England and the Midlands, and it'll be quite damp in the far northwest. Tomorrow, mostly cloudy with some heavy downpours in parts. And that's the BBC News at 3 minutes past eight.
Radio 2. Now, this is the Paul Gambaccini Collection. BBC
Radio 2. Into his car, a great big Cadillac, gangster white walls, TV antennas in the back, diamond in the back, sunroof top, digging the scene with a gangster lean, and I have taken the tube to Maida Vale.
Though you may not drive a great big Cadillac, against the white wall.
Ultimate ABBA song on Radio 2.
It's going to be incredibly difficult to choose, so you can use up to 5 votes for the songs you think should win. When the votes are in, I'll count them down to discover
your ultimate ABBA song.
For full terms, the privacy notice, and to cast your votes, go to bbc.co.uk/ABBA vote. Be quick, voting closes at midday on Thursday, the 18th of April, 2024.
Some nights I stay up, cashing in my bad luck. Some nights I call it a draw. Some nights I wish that my lips could build a castle. Some nights I wish they'd just fall off.
jelly of spring about it. I can hear a lark somewhere begin to sing. Major to minor, every time we say goodbye.
This day in 1951, Janice Fink was born. She found fame as Janice Ian, and she won a Grammy Award with At 17. Can you imagine this moment? Carnegie Hall, on March the 18th, David Lawrence.
At home, inventing lovers on the phone, who called to stall, it seems, it's 17. A brown-eyed girl in hand-me-down, they only get what they deserve. In the rich relationed hometown, even for the elderly. Remember those who win the gaiety and dubious integrity. The small to those of us who knew the pain of Valentine's that never, the world was younger than today, and dreams were all they gave for free to ugly ducklings.
Matter of life and death, someone born on this day, someone who has recently passed away. This day in 1951.